Hello everyone, Daftery with you. Hope everyone's doing well. Today we're going to go in depth on the Phoenix Simulation A320, starting with the flap hydraulic degradation and LMV or leak measurement valves demonstration. Phoenix Sim revealed their Payware A320 project on July 12th, around 2 weeks ago from today. I've heard a lot of positive input from this A320, so I'm looking forward for its release date, which hasn't been announced yet. The first video Phoenix Sim uploaded was an Autoland demonstration done by Fraser in Sydney, but I wanted to dig deep into the items and visual features that a lot of people have yet to see. This A320 reminds me of the TOLIS A321 in X-Plane, even though I never tried X-Plane and TOLIS, but it's somewhat similar to it, so it's promising quality in the products. From here on out, Amir Thakur demonstrates their A320. I'll leave the link to the actual 8-minute video in the description for you to see as he explains the whole concept of the flaps and LMV. I'm just explaining, adding, and pointing out details that's being shown in the video. Their A320 is in the alpha build, so it's still work in progress. Amir discusses on how the flaps and slats work and what drives them to extend and retract. He brings a good point involving the differential gearbox and what hydraulics pressurizes a certain flaps and slats. The general description is a power control unit or PCU that uses two independent hydraulics motors that's coupled together by the differential gearbox that's been said. The green and blue hydraulic powers the slats, and the yellow-green hydraulics powers the flaps. Amir turns off the yellow hydraulics and the PTU. The reason why he turns off the PTU as well is because if you turn off the yellow engine pump off but not the PTU, you'd still have yellow hydraulics because the purpose of the PTU is to transfer pressure from the green system to the yellow system at any time there's a pressure difference of 500 psi. And the same can be said vice versa if green system was turned off. By turning off the PTU, you're preventing the PTU from helping the associated hydraulic to maintain adequate pressure. You'll see an ECAM message on the engine warning display screen. The message will display in amber when the pressure is below 1450 psi, so the message hydraulics underlined in the description of the problem. Engine 2 pump has low pressure followed by a box yellow system low pressure message. On the right of the ECAM message are the effective flight controls in amber. On the system display page, you see the yellow hydraulic pressure indicator drop. The amber box is the engine pump that Amir turned off. When you look at the wheel page, you can see amber indications, which associates the effective flight controls. Spoilers 2 and 4 on both wings and the nose wheel steering are affected and are inoperable. If you look at the hydraulic distribution chart, you can see that he failed the yellow hydraulic, so the associated controls that's pressurized by the yellow system are affected and deemed inoperable. Now before we move on, take a good look at the flight control page, because when you have a problem, the system display page automatically takes you to the affected equipment. So we said spoilers 2 and 4 are affected, but so are the main primary controls. Not all of them, but some of them, like the pitch trim, rudder, and right power of the elevator. But the thing about it is that there's redundancy. So what I mean by that is that we have 3 hydraulics in total, and if we lose one of them, we still have the remaining other 2. So as you can see, the green and blue system act as a backup to help you maintain control of the aircraft. Not as smooth, but it gets the job done. Now after he clears the flight control page, you'll see the status page that gives you a summary of what controls are affected no longer operable, and recommendation or action message on the left. By here you see the words flap slow. If we bring back the hydraulics distribution chart, you can see that both flaps and slats use 2 hydraulics as we said earlier. Since the yellow system is off, we still have the slats pressurized by the blue and green hydraulics, but the flaps are only being pressurized by the green system only. Now the flaps are slow because it states that if one hydraulic system is inoperative, which is the yellow system, the corresponding surfaces, the flaps, will operate at half speed. Amir extends the flaps and you'll notice the slats move as it should because the slats didn't lose any hydraulics, while the flaps extend at a slower rate. In the external view, you'll see the flaps move at half speed. He also shows off the spoilers, and as expected, spoilers 5 and number 3 will deploy. As you see, the aileron's moving. These are the roll spoilers being shown. The 4 outer spoilers are used for roll control, while the 5th spoiler isn't utilized. Now Amir shows you how the circuit breakers work and what happens if you trip one of it. He pulls the hydraulic pressure transmitter circuit breaker, which is green. Now from this part, it's important to understand the difference between the green and black circuit breakers. The green circuit breakers are connected to the Electronic Centralized and Aircraft Monitoring System, ECAM. So any circuit breaker that's been pulled or tripped for more than a minute will show ECAM, circuit breaker trip warning. As for the black circuit breakers, they're not monitored by the ECAM, so you won't be getting any warnings about the black circuit breaker being pulled or tripped. The ECAM wouldn't freak out, it would only give you a confirmatory notification that the associated green circuit breaker has been pulled or tripped. It's nothing major, you just won't have any pressure input data showing on the hydraulics page. It's not really critical, unlike a dual hydraulic, and you'll be hearing a lot of chiming and an ECAM warning message with it. Amir already noted that the leak measurement valves, the LMV, should display off when pressed. Now, when you turn off the LMVs, this is the freakout you'd expect, because when you turn off the LMVs, you're switching off the valves and stopping the hydraulics from pressurizing the flight controls. As you can see from the chart, these are the LMVs. Overall, that's very impressive from Amir and the Phoenix team. This is something I've been eager to try in Microsoft Flight Simulator. I was only able to simulate engine failure and engine fire only, but now with this built-in failure feature, the Phoenix A320 looks promising. So great work from Phoenix Simulations. So that's about it for the Phoenix A320 hydraulic and LMV demo. Hopefully that sheds some light, some informative. If you have any questions, suggestions, feel free to comment down below. Consider subscribing for more videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll be seeing you guys next video. Take care.